Hello, in this video I will show you how to set up the SDL2 library on your macOS Catalina machine. After the installation, I will show you how to build and run a simple SDL2 program that fills the screen with a random color. I'll assume that you've already installed the command line tools and the Homebrew package manager. If this is not the case, I will leave a link in the video description to my previous tutorial, in which I show how to install the above. Open a terminal and use the brew command to search for SDL2. As you can see, there are a few libraries that match our search. You can use the brewinfo command to check the version and a brief description of any of these libraries. From this, we are going to install SDL2, SDL2Image, SDL2Mixer, SDL2Net and SDLTTF. SDL2 is the main library. SDL2Image will let you load and save various image formats. The main SDL2 supports only the BMP image format. SDL2Mixer will let you play music in various formats. The main SDL2 library supports only the WAV image format. SDL2TTF lets you load various true types fonts for use in your code. SDL2Net can be used for simple network programming. For example, you can download, upload files over the network, send messages, and so on. We are done with the installation. As promised, in the next part of the video, I will show you how to build a small C code that uses SDL2 to open a window and fill the background with a random color. For simplicity, I will use an already written program. As usual, you can find the link to the example source code in the video description. Since this program uses only the main SDL2 libraries, we can build it with the next command. Now, you can run the program. If you press the C key on your keyboard, the background color will change randomly. At any time, you can close the program by closing the graphical window. Optionally, I will show you how to use the package config app to search for the required SDL2 libraries. This is useful when you link with more than the SDL2 main library. First, install the package config by using the brew install command. Now, you can compile any SDL2 program with the next command. Thanks for watching and please like, share and subscribe.